Hey guys, today I have 5 Videoleap tutorials to take your edits to the next level. If you're looking for a basic starter tutorial on Videoleap, this might not be the video for you. I'm going to link to a different one down in the description box if you're just starting with the Videoleap app. But if you're more advanced and you're looking to level up your edits, you are in the right place. I'm going to be doing everything on my very sick iPad Pro. If you are in the market for a new tablet, I totally recommend this one. I'll drop it down in the description box. And while I am doing all of these edits on the iPad today, everything I show you also works on the phone app, so don't you worry. All right, let's get right into the first one, which is this text shake effect. All right, let's start by adding media to this Videoleap project. I'm going to select this clip here, and you can see it's these two people running on the beach. Now you can see in my setup that I have the magic keyboard for the iPad Pro, but the Videoleap app doesn't really work with a lot of keyboard shortcuts, so I'm also going to be using the Apple Pencil. I'll link to this guy down below as well. All right, I'm gonna start by adding a text overlay to this clip, and I'm going to edit the text. And let's just customize the font and the color of the text. And I'm going to add a drop shadow to really make that stand out. All right, let's go back and add an animation to this text. So I'm gonna select animation, we're gonna hit in, and let's select the bounce animation. Now let's select our main clip here, and let's go back to our main menu here in Videoleap, and let's select effects, and we're going to select the shake effect. I'm gonna hit the check mark to apply it. And let me just play it back by default so you can see what happens. What we wanna do is reduce the duration of the shake effect and adjust the timing so that the shake happens just as the text bounces in. You may need to play with the timing of the text animation and the shake effect to really make it feel like when that text bounces in, it's disrupting the flow of the whole video. But once you get the timing right, it looks perfect. All right, let's move on to our next tutorial, which is how to make the background black and white, but your subject's full color. All right, once again, we've got this same shot of these people running on the beach. The first thing I'm going to do is select that clip, long press, and hit the duplicate key. Now you can see I've got 2 versions of that same clip in my timeline here. The first thing I'm going to do is select this second clip and hit the cutout option. And what Videoleap does is it magically cuts these people off of the background. And now I'm going to draw my attention back to the first clip, and I'm going to go to the adjustments menu here, and under saturation, I'm going to dial down that saturation so it's just black and white. Now let's draw attention again to the duplication of our clip. I'm going to long press and select the overlay option. And what that's done is it's brought it onto the track above my original clip. And I'm just going to long press and move it so it's perfectly stacked on top of the original clip. And now you can see that my subjects are full color, but that beach is in black and white. For my next tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to make this text animation. This does not come with the Videoleap app, but you can create it if you know how. Let me show you. For this next tutorial, let me show you what I've got here. I've got my clip that we've been working with, and I have a layer of text on top of that. The font on this is Open Sans, and I have it black and all capital letters. For this tutorial, we're gonna be using what are called keyframes in Videoleap. Keyframes are amazing because it allows you to create custom animations right in the Videoleap app. So let me show you how keyframes work. I'm going to cue up my playhead to the very beginning of the text here, and I'm going to select the spacing option, and we're going to select the characters option and dial up that slider all the way to 100. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click this little keyframe button here. It's this diamond in the bottom right of the UI, and you can see inside my text, it's created this red diamond right here. What I have done is I've told Videoleap what I want the value of this character spacing to be at this point in my timeline. Now, what I'm going to do is run my playhead a little bit further down in my timeline, and I'm going to dial down that character spacing all the way down to 0. And you can see what it's done. It's added another keyframe right here on the text in my timeline. So what's going to happen is that that character spacing value is going to change between these two keyframe points, and then it's going to maintain that zero value for the rest of my project. I love this text tracking look. It's very clean and modern, but we just need to polish it up a little bit with one more step here. Again, selected on the text, I'm going to select the animation option. We're going to select in, and we're just going to have it fade in. And that just makes it all look much more polished. My next tutorial combines two techniques I've already shown you. It is the text behind effect, where the text is behind the subjects of our shot, but over the background. To start this one out, we've got the same tracking text effect we already built. Let's draw our attention to our clip here. I'm gonna long press it and duplicate it. I'm gonna select the duplicate and let's use that cutout effect again. And again, I'm gonna long press and select overlay. And then I'm going to long press again and click it and drag it to line up perfectly with the original clip. And then I'm going to select this text element and long press on that and select the backward option. So now the text is one layer behind our cutout subjects. In my last next level Videoleap tutorial is all about bringing free music from outside Videoleap into your Videoleap project. The first thing you're going to need to do is open the Chrome app. So you want to make sure that you're using Chrome and you are going to search for YouTube Studio on Google. Now it's really important that you're not in the YouTube Studio app. You can only do what I'm about to show you on the desktop version of YouTube Studio. So here in the Google search results, what you need to do is long press on the YouTube Studio search result and select this option here, open in new tab. Now here on the left side of the screen, you're going to look for this icon with this musical note inside these squares. And we're going to select the View Tracks button. Now these are all tracks that you can download for free. So you can preview them by clicking the thumbnail of the song and you can see it playing down here at the bottom of the UI. And if you decide you like it, you're just going to hit these three dots here on the right and select download track and then hit the download button here at the bottom of your UI. And then you're going to get this option here that says open in. Click on that. And you will see the Videoleap app here in your options. Now it's really important for you to know that you need to have the project you want to apply this music track to open in Videoleap. So once you know that you've got the right project opened up in Videoleap, just select Videoleap here in this menu and your music cut is automatically dropped right in your Videoleap timeline. And of course you can trim it up to be the perfect length for your video project. So there you go, guys, 5 next level tutorials for Videoleap. Did you like this video? If you want to see more Videoleap tutorials, let me know down in the comments. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today. I picked out some other videos I know you're going to love, and I'll see you again.